A student is studying a species of wolves and must determine the protein formed from four amino acids in the following wolf DNA sequence. In order for the student to determine this, he must first transcribe the DNA into RNA. First, he must establish which strand is the wolf's template strand and which is the coding strand, since the coding strand will possess the four correct amino acids. An important reminder is that T's become U's when transcribing DNA to RNA. While a top strand has a start codon of AUG going from left to right, it fails to produce a stop codon after four amino acids. He then looks at the top strand from right to left and notes that it fails to possess a start codon in this direction as well. He now looks at the bottom strand going from left to right and finds a start codon of AUG, but it too fails to have a stop codon after four amino acids. Finally, after looking at the bottom strand from right to left, the student finds a start codon of AUG and a stop codon of UAA, remembering that the T will become a U after four amino acids, thus deducing that this is the coding strand while the top is the template strand. After transcribing the mRNA from the now established coding strand, the student must now take the mRNA through translation to determine the four amino acids that form the protein. It translates AUG to methionine, the start codon, GUC to valine, AGC to serine, and AAG to lysine, which is followed by the stop codon of UAA. Now that the student has discovered the wild-type mRNA sequence of this species of wolves, he now has to determine the different types of point mutations found in other wolves of this species. He determines this first mutation to be a missense mutation, since it causes a different amino acid to be encoded. This is classified as a transversion, since it goes from pimeridine to purine, cytosine to guanine. He determines the second mutation to be a nonsense mutation, since it encodes a stop mutation instead of an amino acid. This too is classified as a transversion, since it goes from purine to pimeridine, adenine to uracil. He classifies the third mutation as a silent mutation, since the mutation still encodes for the same amino acid as the wild type. This is classified as transition, as it only involves a pimeridine to a pimeridine change, cytosine to uracil. He finds the last mutation to be a read-through mutation due to the fact that it encodes for a regular amino acid instead of a stop codon. This is classified as a transition, since it only involves a pimeridine to a pimeridine change, uracil to cytosine. These are my references.